Why do binary contracts matter? If you listen to me talk, invariably, I'll start talking about stable binary contracts. And the reason why I harp on this so much is because it's critical to what it means to be able to ship binaries to customers for them to consume. In order to be able to consume a binary, the code in that binary has to have been written to a stable binary contract. What that means is that there has to be a well-defined calling convention, a naming convention, all of the things that allow somebody to call code in that module have to be stable. They have to be standardized over time and across compilers. For Windows, this is actually not that bad because the Windows binary contract is a C language contract. And largely because of the ubiquity of Windows, pretty much every C compiler knows how to write code that interoperates with the Windows C compilers, the compilers that are used for Windows. This allows you to create DLLs, shared objects, that are written in C, that can be distributed to customers across the world, and those customers know that they can safely and reliably call into that code. For other languages like C++, there is no stable binary contract. What that means is that C++ code written from one compiler, the objects created from one compiler, won't necessarily work with the objects created from another C++ compiler. Heck, the objects from one version of a C++ compiler may not be compatible with objects created by another version of the same compiler. And what that means in practice is that if you want to distribute a library in C++, you have two choices. You write a C wrapper for that library, a stable binary contract, or you ship the source code to the customer and then let the customer compile your code in whatever environment with whatever compilers they're using. And that way you maintain a binary contract. It's not stable, but at least it's a binary contract that the customer's code will work with.